Welcome to the online lecture series of Turbo Machines. Here is Professor Lakshman Mani. This is lecture on centrifugal compressor part 5, that is pre-whirl, surging and choking of centrifugal compressor. I acknowledge my sincere thanks to the following author and courtesy for being used these concepts to make this video session. In this session, you will be able to explain effect of blade shape on performance of centrifugal compressor. You will be able to explain pre-whirl and its effect on centrifugal compressor. You will be able to explain losses in centrifugal compressor, and you will also be able to explain surging and choking of centrifugal compressor. Let us discuss about effect of impeller blade shape on performance of centrifugal compressor. Shape of blade of centrifugal compressor impeller depends on value of exit vane angle phi. So here are three types. For the vane angle less than 90 degrees, the shape of blade is backward curved vane. For the angle phi is equal to 90 degrees, the shape of blade is of radial vane type. And for the vane angle value greater than 90 degrees, shape of blade is of forward curved vane type. So these three types of vanes with their outlet velocity diagram are shown below. So here first is diagram of backward curved vane shape, where the phi angle is less than 90 degrees. In this diagram, here component U2 is greater than component VW2. In case of radial vane, means phi angle 90 degrees, whirl component at outlet is equal to blade velocity component at outlet. And in the case of forward curved vane, that is phi greater than 90 degrees, here value of VW2 component is greater than U2. We have work done is equal to VW2 U2 in kilojoule per kg. This is responsible to push the air in discharge pipe, hence it is called as Euler's head. So Euler's head, means H, is written as VW2 U2. Say equation number 1. Now from outlet velocity triangle diagram, for the ratio of tan phi, we can have VF2 divided by U2 minus VW2. So by arranging the equation, we can write VW2 is equal to U2 minus VW2 cot phi. Say equation number 2. So we have again from continuity equation, discharge means Q is equal to area into velocity, where velocity is flow velocity at outlet. So flow velocity at outlet means VF2 is equal to Q by A. Now putting this expression in equation number 2, we get VW2 is equal to U2 minus Q by A times cot phi. Say equation 3. Putting equation 3 in equation 1, we get H is equal to bracket U2 minus Q by A cot phi bracket complete U2. Multiplying U2 inside the bracket, we get H is equal to u2 square minus q upon a cot phi u2. From this equation, for constant speed and constant flow area of compressor, value of h means head depends on value of q means discharge. So we can write here h is directly proportional to q. Here are three cases based on angle, vane angle. So here on the vertical axis you lower head and on the horizontal axis discharge. So for first case means for angle phi less than 90 degree, the shape of blade is backward. In this case, value of h, if you see here, this is falling. In the second case means for radial vane, angle phi is 90 degree, here value of h remains constant. That is why here it is indicated by horizontal line. And in third case, for angle vane angle greater than 90 degree means forward curved vane shape, value of h is increasing. Pre-whirl of centrifugal compressor. Relative velocity is having effect on centrifugal compressor. We have formula for Mach number is a ratio of whirl velocity at inlet to square root of gamma RT 1. So from this equation, higher VR value gives higher Mach number, which leads to produce shock waves and increases loss of energy. So for smooth operation of compressor, value of VR is to be reduced. So it is done by giving the air an initial pre-rotation to the absolute velocity V1. So here in this second diagram, you can see here pre-rotation is given to this V1 velocity component. So it reduces this length of VR1. Now this process is called as pre-whirl or pre-rotation. Now for this case, work done is equal to VW2 U2 minus VW1 U1, because here VW1 is not equal to 0. Now for without pre-whirl means for this case, VW1 is equal to 0, hence work is equal to VW2 U2. So about effect of pre-whirl, we can have work done is equal to VW2 U2 minus VW2 minus VW1 U1, because here VW1 is not equal to 0, means this quantity is getting subtracted from this quantity. So it means pre-whirl reduces the compressor work by an amount VW1 U1. Here in this diagram, angle psi is called as angle of pre-whirl. Losses in centrifugal compressor. In this diagram, we see here on the vertical axis losses and on the horizontal axis mass flow rate. Here we see three kinds of curves. This is for frictional losses, this is for incident losses, and this is for total loss. See one by one. Frictional losses. A major portion of the losses is due to friction in stationary and rotating blade passages. So the flow in impeller and diffuser is decelerating in nature, means velocity of air is decreased here. Therefore, the frictional losses are due to both skin friction and boundary layer separation. These losses depend on the friction factor, length of flow passage, and square of the fluid velocity. Second type of loss, that is incident losses. During the off-design conditions, the direction of relative velocity of air at inlet does not match with the inlet blade angle, and therefore fluid cannot enter the blade passage smoothly by gliding along the blade surface. So the loss in energy that takes place because of this is known as incident loss. Third kind of is clearance and leakage losses. As certain minimum clearances are necessary between the impeller shaft and the casing and between the outlet periphery of impeller eye and the casing, the leakage losses comprise a small fraction of the total loss. So the clearance losses depend upon the impeller diameter and the static pressure at the impeller tip. Surging of centrifugal compressor. From the equation of isentropic efficiency, means T02- minus T01 divided by T02 minus T01. Here, if we take common from the denominator and numerator and denominator as a T01, we have here T02- divided by T01 minus 1 divided by T02 divided by T01 minus 1. Now, here for the isentropic process, temperature ratio means T02- divided by T01 is equal to P02 by P01 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. Hence, the above equation becomes P02 by P01 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma minus 1 divided by T02 by T01 minus 1. So, from this, here we can observe value of P02 by P01 ratio. If it increases, isentropic efficiency increases. Here is a diagram of H means Ullur's head versus mass flow rate. So here operation of the compressor is shown with different points from A to F. So portion A, B, C, it has positive shape, positive slope, and portion C, D, E, F, it has negative slope. If you see at point A, here value of m dot is 0, means discharge valve is closed condition, and at point F, here value of m dot is maximum, means your discharge valve is in fully open condition. At point C, this is a point where head value is maximum, and point A and point F, these are end conditions. So here when load on compressor increases, mass flow rate decreases. So here if you see point number E, because of decreasing mass flow rate, in case of load on compressor increasing, point E will shift to E dash. At this point, operation of the centrifugal compressor is stable. That's why this region is shown here with tick mark. Now here at point B, due to frictional loss, if head is reduced, point B is shifted to B dash, means compressor developed head at this point is less than required head. Now compressed developed head is responsible to move the air in delivery pipe of the compressor, but when compressor developed head is less than required head, This will result in reversal of flow of air, and compressor operation is unstable. So that's why in this region it is shown with cross mark. So pulsating of air occurs here, and which is called as surging of compressor. Choking of centrifugal compressor. Choking is the condition which occurs in the compressor, in which it operates at very high mass flow rate and flow through the compressor can't be further increased. So here from this diagram, at point F, here flow rate is maximum, but here head is zero, and practically at point G, here flow rate is maximum, but it is limited by wall, which is called choking of the compressor. Means beyond this point, here mass flow rate can't be further increased. So this is a condition of choking of centrifugal compressor. So at the end of this session, you can explain effect of blade shape on performance of centrifugal compressor. You can explain pre-whirl and its effect on centrifugal compressor. You can explain losses in centrifugal compressor, and you can explain surging and choking of centrifugal compressor. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. Thank you.